In 2000, rapper Marshall Mathers, or better known as Eminem, was not only a rap icon, but one of the biggest celebrities of the time.
Will the real Slim Shady please stand up?
He had previously come out with the Slim Shady LP, which introduced the world to Eminem's alter ego, Slim Shady. In 2000, he came out with the Marshall Mathers LP, an intense look at the criticism and backlash that came from his first album with hits like Stan and The Way I Am, which both showcase a different side to Marshall not seen from the mostly upbeat and jokey Slim Shady LP, minus a couple tracks.
All of this controversy circles me, and it seems like the media immediately points a finger at me. So I point one back at him, but not the index or pinky, or the ring or the thumb. It's the one you put up when you don't give a f- when you won't just put up with the bull they pull.
With two immensely successful albums behind him, Eminem decided the next possible medium for him to tackle was web cartoons. Not what I or most people would expect from a hardcore rapper to do, but to each their own, I guess. On September 16th, 2000, the very first episode of The Slim Shady Show was released on Eminem's very own slice of the early 2000s internet, SlimShadyWorld.com. Doesn't get any more early 2000s from here. It's not up anymore, but you can still go to it via the Wayback Machine. But I suppose we should talk about the actual show.
There is a Wikipedia page for this show, but it's French. So I think that really gives you a good idea of how many people actually give a shit about this show. That also means that a lot of this info is questionable, honestly.
It's no secret that Eminem was a fan, and in some cases inspired by South Park, but attempting to rip them off completely was probably not a smart decision. You could tell he wanted this to be his South Park, in a way. And to be completely fair, if he poured the same amount of effort into the show that he did with his music videos and records, it could have been okay, but it's not exactly South Park. It's more, remember the Nut Shack? Yeah, it's more like the Nut Shack. For those of you who are lucky enough not to know what The Nut Shack is, The Nut Shack was an adult animated cartoon that ran on Mix TV from 2007 to 2011. Never heard of Mix TV? Yeah, neither have I. From what I can tell, they're like the Filipino-American version of MTV? I don't fucking know. The Nut Shack was heavily criticized for its mediocre voice acting, its horrible animation, and its even worse comedy.
Next time I see you, your wrinkly nuts will be going down!
What did you say? You're going down on my nuts?
What?
The Slim Shady Show is essentially the Nutshack beta version 1.0. I guess the first thing to talk about would be its art style. It kinda really sucks. Now granted, this is a web cartoon that came out in 2000, but this is still beyond shitty. Remember when I said Eminem wanted this to be his very own South Park? I guess he was really going for authenticity because this animation is as simplistic as you can get. There aren't even frames between arm and leg movements, it just looks awful, especially compared to the extremely smooth tweening this show does, like whenever a car is on the screen. It's like they saw South Park's cardboard cutout animation style and they thought, hey, we don't have to try. Half the time, the mouths are in sync with the audio.
I can't believe they beat us that bad.
God damn, we motherfucking suck.
The designs themselves aren't particularly bad, but they aren't particularly good either. They all have this thick outline 2D design that would probably look nice, if not for the before-mentioned animation and the honest-to-god awful-looking backgrounds and props, not to mention the nauseating color palette. The article on Wikipedia I mentioned earlier states that the designs are based on the music video for a role model, but in reality they don't look all that similar. I'm guessing they had more of a budget for the music video than the web cartoon, plus animating a couple seconds of animation for a music video is most likely much less expensive and time-consuming than an entire 5-minute episode. I suppose since we're on the topic of designs, I should bring up our lovable cast of characters. There's the titular Slim Shady, Eminem's alter ego from both the Slim Shady and Marshall Mathers LP. Then there's Marshall, who's supposed to be younger Eminem, I believe. I don't know, it's an interesting concept making Marshall Mathers and Slim Shady completely different characters, but they don't do anything interesting with it at all. What's even more confusing is that in one episode they actually show Eminem in prison.
Hey, Eminem. Who's got the juice now?
Yo, I ain't even supposed to be in here yet. I ain't been convicted. I'll see y'all in a minute.
It's just plain confusing. Then there's Ken Keniff from the previous two Eminem albums.
Who's this? This is Ken Keniff. Who? Ken Keniff from Connecticut, little bitch.
From Connecticut.
And he's just a gay stereotype. Look, I know stereotypes, especially in media, are controversial in this day and age. Honestly, I just don't give a fuck. If your character is a stereotype, I just care if your character is endearing or funny. Unfortunately, Ken Keniff isn't any of these things. He's just an uninteresting gay stereotype. That's his entire character. And that's more or less where the remotely interesting or Eminem-related characters end. There's Dave, who's just a stoner stereotype. That's his character. Then there's Knuckles.
Knock, knock, it's Knuckles.
And he's more or less just a generic token black guy.
Okay, never mind. I don't know who the fuck this is.
I know I'm generalizing most of these characters as X stereotype, and that's the character, but that's really all I can say for them. Only thing noteworthy about Knuckles is that he's voiced by Exhibit. Then there's Sue, who's the token girl of the group, and that is her character. There's a bunch of other less important characters in this show, but I can't be arsed to mention them all here. Now I suppose I should talk about the most important aspect of an adult animated comedy, the actual comedy itself. Now, remember what I said about this show being similar to the Nutshack? Yeah.
You got no Game Boy. All you got is that game you play by yourself in a banyo.
Much like the Nutshack, the comedy here is really only some kind of sex/drug reference, or some kind of pop culture reference. Now to be fair, pop culture-related comedy can be done right, but in the world of adult animation, it's highly rare. Its comedy is more or less completely based in the year 2000. The before-mentioned translated Wikipedia article actually has an entire section alone on all the pop culture the show shits on. But Jesus Christ, for all the similarities of Eminem bashes in his songs, you would think there would be some kind of clever and funny writing in this show, right?
Man, you two suck. Your movies suck, and we all know you shouldn't be movie stars.
No talent, punks.
Yeah, the show isn't funny now, and something tells me it wasn't funny then. It has the same problem shows like Family Guy and the Nutshack have. It's not clever, it's not funny, and above all, it doesn't stand the test of time. Do I recommend the Slim Shady Show? Unless you're sadistic and want to torture yourself or someone else, no.